You crazy. Hey boo. If you are a content creator like me and you can't figure out how to convert horizontal videos to vertical so they fit all these trendy platforms right now like TikTok, Reels, whatever, I got you sis. You're gonna want to watch this video because I have some tips for you. And I forgot to mention, if you only have iMovie, you can totally do that. That's my chair. So watch this video.
I can't afford buying this expensive ass software, so all I have is iMovie and my phone, but I'm filming my YouTube videos with my Canon camera and I'm editing them with iMovie. I can't transfer them to my phone because that's pura locura, so I can't do that. All I have is iMovie. So if you are someone like me, this video is for you.
So are you guys ready to be amazed? Buckle up, because this is the easiest editing tips I found. So first you want to open your project. This is my little project. I'm going to open it. I already did some of the editing you see right here, and my laptop is acting up. I don't know why it's so slow. I don't know why. Okay, first of all, you want to crop down your video. This video was at 17 minutes long and now I have it at 28 seconds. So you want to crop the video to include only the parts you want to show in your TikTok video. Let's say that. As you can see, I have a bunch of 1 second long videos. So first you want to select the clip, okay? Then you're gonna go up here where you have the editing tools and you're going to press on the cropping. So you're gonna press on the cropping icon, you see? And then you want to rotate the clip counterclockwise, okay? So now you have this. It looks vertical, but that's not what we want, right? Then you're gonna go where it says crop to fill and select the part you want to show in your video. Mine, I want to keep it center so you can see the eye, but depending on your content, you do you. Like, select whatever parts you want from the clip to show in your video, okay? Okay, my laptop is acting. Don't mind that. So as I said, mine, I want to be focused in the center so you can see the eye. This is a makeup tutorial, but as I said, depending on your content, select the part you want to include in the video. Then you're gonna go here where it says apply crop adjustment. Okay, and I know it doesn't look vertical, but trust the process, okay? So you're gonna repeat the exact same steps to every single little clip on your timeline. Okay, so I'm going to do that. Make sure it's centered, okay, and apply the adjustments. Okay, laptop. You can also use the Ken Burns option to give the video a little oomph. It will make it look a little bit more professional. I don't know, that's just my opinion. But in my case, I just want the image to stay focused in one point. So I can't use this because it will be annoying. But depending on your content, use it. It will look cool. Okay, now that we inverted every single clip, you want to go over them and see if everything is center and if it looks how you would want to look. I already did that and my videos are centered and my eye is in the center. You can totally see what I'm doing in the video. Now you want to go and export it as usual. So I like to go back and share project and file. Then I like to compress it at better quality. So as you can see, resolution again is 1080, and I know you don't want that, but as I said, trust the process. You'll see in a second how we're gonna make this look vertical. I'm going to export my video and I'm going to rename it maybe. Okay, so my video was successfully exported. Next, I'm going to open it with QuickTime. Okay, so I have my video right here. This is the video. This is how it looks. Now we are going to open it with QuickTime. Then you want to go, let me make this a little bit smaller. Then you want to go where it says flip to the, oh, I'm sorry, rotate to the right. to the right, to the right. Alrighty, now you want to go and save it. Where is save? The save button. Where is the save button? I think it's saved already. Let's just try to close it. Oh yeah, now it asks you to save it. So rename it. And I want to, yeah, save this on the desktop. And honestly, I don't know. You choose whatever size you want. I'm going to go with this one right here. And I'm going to save it. And I think it's gonna take a while. Oh no, it's pretty fast. Alrighty, so let's see if that worked. It didn't. What the fuck? Oh, wait a second. We saved this on desktop. So this is how it looks. This is the final result. I hope you guys enjoyed this editing tutorial. Honestly, I haven't done anything like this so far. So please bear with me. Depending on how far or close you filmed your video, as you can see, some clips are closer, some are a little bit further. So you can see my entire face, but that's how I film my makeup tutorials. This is what I have. This is what I'm going to work with. In the captions on TikTok, I'm going to say that full tutorial is on my YouTube channel, so the public will go there and watch it. I mean, obviously, if they want to. And you guys, once again, full credit goes to this guy right here. Watch his video because he's probably a little bit more explanative than I am. I honestly don't know how to explain things. I just use my own words and sometimes it's not the best. I really liked his video and I'm going to let him know in the comments that he did a great job sharing this video with us. Like, this is great content right here, okay? So please go support your small content creators, because as you can see, some of us post great helpful content out there. So please support your small creators. I will be having his video in my description down below, so check his video out as well.
Depending on how close, okay, or far you're gonna film your videos, it will look closer or further away. So I personally film makeup tutorials. I want you guys to see everything, so that's why I film them very close, so you can see all the details, so you can see everything. But I could, if I want to, I could film them a little bit further away so they will fit much better in the vertical form. And obviously it will look much better on TikTok reels, shorts, whatever. But because I want you, like my main focus is YouTube, so I want you to see everything. That's why I'm filming my videos this close, because I want you to see every freaking thing. Every detail, every color, everything. You know what I mean? I want to keep it very real here on my channel. So I'm going to show you the final result of the video that I just edited with you guys here on camera. So this is the end result. I'm on my TikTok right now, so I'm going to have it here on the screen as well. But this is how it looks. This is very close. Very, very close. This is a little bit further away and it looks, in my opinion, it looks okay. But then at the end, I have a clip that I'm a little bit further away and that, in my opinion, looks much better. But it's just personal preference. You can totally see what I'm doing in these little clips. Like, it fits the screen. It looks okay still. You see, this clip was a little bit further away. So there you have it. I really hope this video was helpful. If you are a content creator like me and you cannot figure out, for the love of God, how to convert horizontal videos to vertical, I really hope this video is helpful. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And also don't forget to check this guy out so you watch his video as well. As I said, probably he is a little bit more explanative. He explained it better than me. Obviously, I'm using my own words. My English is not that vast, okay? My English is not amazing, but I use my own words. And I really hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Anyway, I really hope I could help you guys, and that's it. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Take care, and I will see you in my next one.